Are you the new tenant? I just saw the tenant like 10 minutes ago standing in the doorway.
Oh, I hate to break it to you, but there is no person in number 5.
You have to understand that there is a war waging in heaven.
On a rare occasion, a special child appears.
Is everything all right?
No.
The curse, the Lords of Salem, possessing the souls of the Salem women, which the devil's child would inherit the earth.
Satan, come to us!
All right, South by Southwest 2013, we are here on the red carpet for Lords of Salem. The noise you hear behind me is the crowd cheering for Rob Zombie and Sherry Moon Zombie showing up, and we're going to talk to them right now. You're so much different in person than people expect, right?
That's the best compliment. I want to be totally different from my character, so I guess I'm doing an okay job.
Yeah, well, what can you tell us about this one?
Well, this movie, I play a character who is a DJ in a radio station, and she receives a mysterious record album. Who even knows what those are anymore, but one day, and every time she hears the music, like, strange things start to happen, and are they hallucinations, are they real, you know, I don't know.
Sounds like a Rob Zombie record.
Yeah.
We're going to find about your character, because the Rob Zombie characters are beloved among film fans, so what are we going to see from you here?
What are you going to see from me? You're going to see a guy, it's going to be like a Hansel and Gretel, but I'm Hansel, and I'm totally clueless what Gretel's up to and with the witch.
Well, we're here with the one and only Rob Zombie at South by Southwest, and we're really, really excited about this film. And we've been reading reviews that have said something along the lines of more grown-up and mature and sophisticated, those kind of words. What do you think when you read stuff like that?
Hey, if that makes people happy, it's great, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's really, you know, it's whatever people think is fine. I don't know. Sometimes it's funny when you read stuff like that. I don't know.
I mean, we love the films and we love to see the evolution of it. So were you excited to unleash this on everybody?
Yeah, I mean, I was really excited to get it out. I mean, it feels like we've been done with it forever. And so, yeah, just getting it out there finally is good so I can stop talking about it and move on to something else.
Like the music. You got a new album coming out.
Yeah, the album and the movie basically come out almost the same day. So there's a lot of business going on.
Yeah. For sure. The last thing, that the show is the Drew Pearson Show, and Drew famously caught the Hail Mary catch. And what would you say is your Hail Mary moment, where you just had to go for something and it worked out for you?
Well, there's probably been a lot of them, but I remember the one that seemed the craziest at the time was right around the time that White Zombie was breaking. We had a song, Thunderkiss, that was starting to become a hit. We got offered a lot of money to put it in a TV commercial. I mean, I was flat broke at the time. And my thing was to not do that, because I thought, we will become the TV commercial band and not a real band. And that's hard. That's a hard decision to make when you're starving. And that was it. And I think that worked out, because I think that would have destroyed us at that moment had we done it.
Yeah, that's great. Well, we're really excited about this movie. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully you get to do some South by Southwest centric.
I doubt it. I'm sure I'll just be doing press all day.
Yeah.
It won't be any fun.
All right, I'll see you later. Thank you.